You know who it was? It was Von Miller. It was toward the end of my career. So now I have confidence. I'm starting for the Chargers. I'm playing center. I'm not going to go against Von very often, but on stunts, he's going to come into the A-gap, B-gap. And every time I faced him when I was playing against the Denver Broncos, I had this feeling in the pit of my stomach because I could see it coming and I knew I had nothing for him. I had nothing for him. I mean, I would say to myself, well, hopefully this cut block works because I'm launching myself at his thigh boards. He just was like cat quick, and he was slender framed, and he got skinny in a hurry, and he was just so dynamic as a rusher. When he was looping around to the A-gap and we had a little space to dance, I said, you're winning this one, pal. Throw it! Yes. Yeah. Okay, so a dual threat quarterback is leaving his prime at 30. A pocket passer is entering his prime at 30.
Great point.
So when Tom Brady, if you look at all of his Pro Bowls, the majority of them are post 30 because you really find out who you are. You mature in offense. And of course, he stayed in the same offense with only two coordinators, Billy O'Brien and Josh McDaniels, during his tenure there in New England. He was able to mature and become the player of prominence that we see him today. A lot of that has been done post 30. You could say the same thing about Drew Brees. But a lot of these mobile quarterbacks, they're leaving their prime at 30.
Yeah, they've gotten dinged.
Cam Newton, Andrew Luck, Carson Wentz is heading in that direction. We'll see how long it lasts with Russell Wilson, but some of the best may already be behind him.
We've reached the point of diminishing returns. We haven't. Because in these cases, as we've seen with Tyreek Hill, as we're seeing with Kareem Hunt, who's serving a half-season suspension, he'll be back and he'll help the Browns a lot on that rushing game. Yeah. What we've seen in the past is representative of this point. If there's talent on the side of the accused, you wait. And you wait a good long time. And Antonio Brown is talented. Targeted 8 times, 4 catches, 56 yards, a touchdown in his debut as a Patriot against Miami. Hapless Miami team, I understand that. But he even had a rush. I mean, they were working him into that game plan. Yeah. They are going to squeeze and wring that rag of every single bit of offensive production before the hammer is laid down by the NFL. Yeah, and that is a legislative hand that lays the hammer hard and fast when it is a talentless situation. This is a quite talentful situation.
5 guys that can play man.
Up next, it's Eastern Michigan coming to SDCCU Stadium, 7:30 kick this Saturday. And they beat Purdue, and then they went and they lost to Buffalo. So who are these guys?
Which quarterback's in the game?
Now, from a defensive standpoint, Eastern Michigan, pretty vanilla as far as what I've seen so far. Like to run that 4-3 against personnel you guys use. What are you expecting out of them this weekend?
Well, that's what
you know. And speaking specifically about the offense, are they spreading it out just like everyone else seems to be doing, just like the Sun Devils did last week?
It's very.
Hey, thanks, Jim. And you know, every offensive coordinator licks their chops when you get into the low red zone, and the 5-yard line is exactly where we get started on the first play breakdown here, Cam. So it's 17-28. You got to get creative at the goal line. How did they get this done on this first play?
Lights out chemistry together.
So basically, what happened is the first option wasn't available, so they went for the number 2. That's exactly what happened tonight, Cam. Usually it's Camarillo in front of you. I took the reins. I hope we got it done, Jim.
Pretty good for an O-line guy.
Great work. Up next, a look at this week's player of the